All right, we have had an awesome day of camp today. I hope you guys had a lot of fun. We have studied God's word, we've captured some flags, we've eaten some good food. It has been an awesome, awesome day, and we're going to look at some scripture tonight. But first, I want to ask you a question. Raise your hand if you have a brother or a sister. Brother or a sister? All right. Now, how many of you guys like to compete with your brother or sister? Like, it's constantly a competition. Oh, we got some old people that think that too, some grown-ups. Awesome. All right, let me tell you about my brother. My brother is 3 years older than me. He is extremely athletic, and he is a scout for the Texas Rangers. I mean, he's super athletic, man. And Pastor John is just not so much that. And so everything was a competition, and one that I would lose every time. So my brother and I, we'd play games together. We had a huge willow tree next to our house, and he would climb up it, and I would try to get him. But one time, I tried to get as high as he did, and I fell, and I broke my arm. Really, really bad. My mom was really upset, came flying down the stairs, went outside, picked me up. I fell just like this, on my arm out of this tree. But I thought I could do everything that my brother could do, but I just couldn't. One day he was playing Hot Box. Have you ever played this game, this baseball game, Hot Box, where you run back and forth between bases and they try to get you out? And I was not good enough to play this game, so I just went and swung around a tree right in the middle of the game. I just put my arm out and swung around. And my brother, my big giant brother, jumped on my arm and broke it again. Isn't he mean? Yeah, he's kind of mean. Broke my arm again. And we were always competing. The only thing I could ever beat him at, does anyone watch wrestling in here? Anybody ever watch wrestling? The only thing I could beat him on was jumping on the top of the couch and going, wah! And jumping on him. We'd strap pillows to ourselves, but I had a little bit more heft. So I could really just knock the wind out of that little booger jumping from that couch, and then whack! That was really like my favorite thing to do. But one day we went to the grocery store, and there was like a hardware store and a grocery store and a big walkway between them. And between each of the stores, when you got to the store, there were these little mats that you step on the door and the door opens up. Have you guys ever seen those before? Sometimes it's like just magic and knows you're there. But back when I was a kid, they had these rubber mats, and when you stepped on it, the door would open and you could go in the grocery store. Well, I raced my brother every time we went to the grocery store. I lost every time. But this time I thought, all right, gonna give it a shot. And we were at the hardware store and we were heading for the grocery store. My mom is rolling her eyes, thinking we're crazy. And we take off running. And I'll talk about this a little bit more tomorrow night, but when I run, it's really horrible and embarrassing. And it's like this. It's just that violent. So don't be around me when I run. But there's lots of flailing. My legs are everywhere. And so it's super embarrassing, but I'm running towards this door. My brother's running towards the door on the right. And we take off running. And I get farther and farther, and I notice he's not there anymore. I'm like, I'm winning! And I'm excited. I look to see why he's not there anymore. And he stopped. But I should have stopped, but I didn't know how close I was to the door. So when I turned, I kept kind of going to the right. And instead of hitting my little mat, I hit the glass door in between the two doors, like the glass wall, and went like this. Like full force into the glass. If you've been to a grocery store like that, you've probably seen there's gumball machines and the little things you put a quarter in and get prizes. That's on the other side of this glass. I bust through the glass. I fall over the gumball machines and all the little toy machines, and I'm laying in a pile of glass and gumballs. What do you think Pastor John thought of first, laying in a pile of glass? Eat the gumballs! So I'm like trying to eat as many gumballs as I can. My mom is mortified that I've broken the door, broken the big glass window. My brother is on the ground laughing. Of course, just cackling. I look around, I don't see any blood, picking up some gumballs, trying not to eat glass. And the manager of the store walks over and stands over me. And I thought, whoa. And he was my neighbor. And he looked down at me, and he just picked me up and said, go. See, I was kind of wild, so everybody kind of expected this, but I was really embarrassed because I had broken this window, and I thought, pay for it, I don't know how I'm going to do that. But he just picked me up, he showed me grace, and said, go shop. So we went shopping, and my mother just hung her head the whole time we were in the store embarrassed. As my brother just cackled. But the reason, one of the reasons that I didn't know if my brother was there, why he had stopped, was because I don't have depth perception. Has anyone ever heard of depth perception? All right, so this is a problem for many things. All right, so right now, if you can see through my eyes, you are all in one row. Oh, that was exciting. So because I don't have depth perception, I can't tell how far things are apart. So right now it's like you're all in one row, your heads are just different sizes. Isn't that weird? All right, so I couldn't tell if I was a mile from that door or feet from that door, which made me have a little trouble doing that. Now, how many of you are good at playing basketball? Anybody in here? All right. See, I didn't know I didn't have depth perception, and I played basketball all the way through junior high, and every ball I shot went whoop, 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 like I could never get it in there. I was like, what is happening? And sometimes from the front, I could bank it off the backboard and make it in, but never from the side. Well, I thought, well, that's weird. I'm really trying, but it's not working. And I didn't know I didn't have depth perception, so I took my driver's test. And in Missouri, when you take your driver's test, they have this test where you look at it and they say, which sign jumps out to you? And I said, none of them. And they're like, next screen, which sign jumps out? I'm like, none of them. They're like, how do you drive? And I was like, I don't know. If the sign's past me, I think I'm, you know, I should stop. But if it's to the side, I need to stop. But the depth perception problem had a lot of problems with my sports and activities. How many of you are good at baseball? Some of you? All right, baseball, also a problem. You gotta know where the ball is to hit it with that bat. All right, how many of you are good at music? Good singers? All right, I heard you guys singing tonight. It was beautiful and awesome. All right, how many of you guys play instruments, like the trumpet or the trombone or the flute? Some of you? All right, a lot of you have a lot of really good talents in the room. All right, here are some of my favorite things. How many of you are good listeners? How many of you are good listeners? Some of you? How many of you are good talkers? Good talkers? All right, awesome. Now everybody look this way. I want you to think today of what you're good at. All right, think of one thing that you're good at. All right, think of that to yourself. If it's a sport, if it is being a good friend, if it's listening, if it's talking. All right, because God can use all of these different talents for Him. And I didn't know that for a long time because I'm a good talker and I like to talk a lot. And every year on my grade card, the box got checked that said excessive talking. Anyone else in the room doesn't know when to not talk? All right. What's awesome about that is one year I got my grade card and the box wasn't checked and my mom took me out to Pizza Hut because pizza is my love language. And she took me out and she fed me and then later we found out the teacher forgot. But I'd already eaten the pizza, wasn't going to give it back. So God can use all the different things you're good at. I had no idea that when I kept getting excessive talking that God could use me to spread the gospel and to tell people about Him. And I've never stopped doing that since I found out that's what God could do through me. So the talents you have, God can use them. Now something we're going to look at tonight in Scripture is something a little bit different than your talents, all right? There's things you're good at, things that God created you to be good at as a kid, things that you are just naturally good at. But we're going to look at something called spiritual gifts tonight and take it a step further and look at the talents and gifts you have. God can use those. But these gifts that only God can give you, we're going to look at those tonight in 1 Corinthians. So grab your Bible. We're going to look at 1 Corinthians chapter 12, verse 4. That's where we're going to start tonight. 1 Corinthians, chapter 12, starting in verse 4. All right, 1 Corinthians, Old Testament or New Testament, friends? New Testament, awesome. 1 Corinthians, chapter 12, starting in verse 4. I'll give you a second to find it. You can use your table of contents, because that's why I got to put it there, because it's awesome. So you can look there. 1 Corinthians 12, verse 4. All right, you have it, put your thumb up. I don't have enough hands to have thumbs up, but you do. Awesome. All right, give me another couple seconds to find it. 1 Corinthians chapter 12, starting in verse 4. All right, thumbs up if you have it. All right, awesome. You read along silently in your copy of God's Word. I'm going to read out loud from mine. And if you don't have a Bible with you, you can look off of a friend there, or you can listen real closely as I read this, all right? Verse 4 says, now there are a variety of gifts, all right? These are those spiritual gifts we're talking about tonight. Different than your talents, these are gifts from God. There are a variety of gifts for the same Spirit, all right? Who did we talk about this morning as our helper that God sent to us? Do you remember? What is that helper that God sends us to guide us? Holy Spirit, okay? So this is the giver of the gifts, right? God and His Holy Spirit gives us these gifts. Now there are varieties of gifts, but the same Spirit, and there are varieties of service, but the same Lord, and there are variety of activities, but it's the same God who empowers them all and everyone. Right, look at verse 7. To each is given the manifestation of the Spirit for the common good. All right, that just means God's giving you something that you can use to further the kingdom and to work together with your friends to help other people. All right, verse 8 says, for to one is given through the Spirit the utterance of wisdom. Right? There's one of the gifts. Right? The utterance of wisdom. To another, the utterance of knowledge according to the same Spirit. To another, faith by the same Spirit. To another, gifts of healing by the one Spirit. To another, the working of miracles. To another, prophecy. To another, the ability to distinguish between spirits. To another, various kinds of tongues. To another, the interpretation of tongues. All these are empowered by one and the same Spirit who apportions to each one individually as he wills. All right? Now, there's some things you've probably not heard of or thought about as these different gifts, all right? But I want you to think about, first, what is the talent that you have that you talked about? What's one of those talents, things that you're good at? And think, how can God use that for him? Think of that first, all right? If you're good at baseball, how can he use that for the kingdom? Can you share the gospel with teammates, all right? Can you use that platform to meet other people who don't know him? Can you be so awesome at baseball that everyone thinks you're awesome and tells you how great you are, and you can say, you know what? God's given me these talents. All right, so think about that first, and now think about these gifts, all right? The Bible says that the Holy Spirit gives us these gifts, right, when we become a Christian, basically. So when you... A lot of you this morning raised your hand and said that you've already prayed and asked Jesus into your life. You've become a Christian. So at that moment, the Holy Spirit gives you gifts. And you might not have thought about that before. And it's really cool. So he gives you these spiritual gifts to use for his kingdom so others may know about him. All right? He also can give you different gifts at different times when you need them. All right? So there are gifts you have now that you may have forever, but there may be other gifts he gives you as you grow. So I want you to think about these gifts, and I read them and think, are these some of the gifts that God may have already given me, or are these things that he might give me based on how I'm wired? All right, so one of the things mentioned there is the gift of wisdom. All right, that means that when you're reading the Bible, you understand things from God and can tell other people what those mean. All right, that God helps you be wise and know things from him that you can share with other people. All right, so that might be a gift that he's given you. Knowledge, this is a fun one. Are you able to learn lots and lots of stuff and pack it in your brain? All right? I'm not very good at that. It's not one of my key gifts. You should see my math scores. It's horrible. All right? But I don't have the gift of knowledge. But if you can learn lots and lots of information and be able to share that, you may have that gift. Faith is an awesome gift, which was talked about in this passage. There's numerous passages about gifts. Faith is something, one of the gifts that I have. It's in the middle of any circumstance, being able to trust and know that God is working all things together for good. All right? It's trusting him in the middle of everything. I have faith all the time that things are going to work out. God's in control. That may be one you have. Giving. Raise your hand if you've ever heard about a need and given some money to help. Some of your allowance or something, even if it was 50 cents to help someone. All right? One of the gifts God talks about is giving. Is he going to use you to take your physical money and help somebody? All right. How many of you like to have friends over to your house, people over to hang out? All right. You may have the gift of hospitality. You may like to entertain people, have them over. Any of you do any cooking, like I talked about with Fry Daddy? All right. Now that is, you can use that as a gift of hospitality to serve other people and to help them get fed and to have a good time in people's houses. All right. Here's some other ones real quick. Helping. How many of you guys like to help other people? All right. That's a spiritual gift, the gift of helps. Serving. Anybody like to serve or volunteer places or volunteer church? All right, that's a gift. Serving. Leadership. Anybody like to be a line leader at school? Pastor John always loved that. All right, leadership. You might be a leader. All right, there's another one that's really fun. This is a fun word. Exhortation. Say exhortation. All right, that means encouraging people. How many of you guys like to encourage people? Either write notes to them or tell them they're doing a great job? All right, so lots of encouraging today in the Capture the Flag game we played earlier. There's also the gift of teaching, if you like to teach people things that you know. Or one of my favorites is the gift of evangelism. All right, if you love to tell other people about Jesus, you may have the gift of evangelism. We should all tell people about Jesus, But if you really love to do that and you can't stop doing it, it's probably because you have the gift of evangelism and God has given you that. All right? We should all go and tell. But there's some people that just have this knack. They just want to tell everyone they know about Jesus. So here's what I want you to think about tonight. All right? First, I want you to think in your mind of someone that you need to encourage tonight. All right? About their gifts that you see in them or their talents. There may be people in your bunkhouse that have no idea what they're good at. No one's ever told them something that they're good at. So it would be really awesome if everybody went to sleep tonight knowing one thing they're good at. Wouldn't that be cool? All right, so if you're sitting around the bunk, you might talk about things you're good at. You might see if everyone can think of one of those things. And if they can't, help them think about that. Because all the way on here on the bus or on the van or as we're playing games today, you'd be able to see in your friends, the ones that came with you to church, you'd be able to see something you can point out. All right? I'm a good eater. Just tell me that. All right? Tell me if I'm a good listener, good talker, good at sports, all those things. So think about that. Who can you encourage tonight to help them know that they have talents and abilities that God has given them? And maybe even encourage them to think about some gifts God might give them, either if they're a Christian already or when they become a Christian. All right? Second, I want you to think personally, do you know of something that you're good at? All right? Do you know a talent that God has given you? And then can you think of any of those things that we talked about tonight that might be a gift from God? All right? One of those gifts we talked about, spiritual gifts. All right? And you might even talk to some of your leaders tonight to help them and encourage you, something you're good at, or something that you might have a gift from God. All right? And the third question I want to talk about tonight is, do you know the giver of those gifts? Do you know God? All right? So like I shared, you don't get these gifts just walking down the street. It doesn't just like fall from the sky and on you. You get these gifts from God when you ask Him to come into your life and you pray to become a Christian. That's when those spiritual gifts arrive. All right? So I want to look tonight at the gospel that we talked about last night. And I have two questions for you tonight as we walk through this. So that slide will come up on the screen. And I just want to walk through this first. All right? First thing I want to talk to you about is if you are a kid or an adult in this room, I want you to think about if you've already prayed to become a Christian, how do you know that you're saved? How do you know that you and God are cool, that you guys are good? All right? How can you know for sure that you and God are good? And I want you to think to yourself, if you've already prayed to become a Christian, think to yourself right now, did I pray and mean it and ask Jesus to come into my life? All right, think back to when you did that. You might have been 5, like we heard from one of the band members today. You might have been 7 or 8, or maybe even 12, like me. Think to yourself, did I pray and mean it? Because the Bible says that if you call on the name of the Lord, you will be saved. All right, not, it's iffy. All right, you call on the name of the Lord, but it's going to take a minute for Him to figure it out. All right, it says, if you call on the name of the Lord, you will be saved. So if you prayed and meant that, and asked Jesus into your life, and He was with you, do you think that He ever walks away and leaves you? No. He's there with you. Now, it might feel like He's not there because you've been distant or you've gotten busy playing video games and not thinking about God, but He's always been there with you. He'll never leave you or forsake you. So if you have prayed and meant that, then you and God are good. All right? And if you need to talk to your group leaders about that and really feel like tonight you nailed it down trying to get rid of that worry or thoughts that you might not be a Christian, talk to them about that tonight or talk to one of our silo staff tonight about that. They love to clear that up so you never worry about that again. All right? Now, if you are not sure if you ever did that or if you are not a Christian and you know you've never prayed and asked Jesus into your life, let's clear that up tonight as well. So we're going to walk through this. And I just want you to think tonight, if you believe these things, and see if it might be time for you to become a Christian tonight in this room. Alright, so just like we looked at last night, do you believe that God rules? Alright, think to yourself, do you believe that? That God created you, He created me, He created the whole world, that the whole purpose of this world is Him. Alright, so if you are not a Christian especially, think about that tonight. Do you believe that? Second thing, do you believe that you've sinned? Done those things God doesn't like? All right? Do you know that you've done those things and that you don't want to do those things anymore? All right? Because God wants us not to do that. So we want to turn away and not do that. Now, if we know we've sinned and we ask Him to forgive us and we even ask Him into our lives, are we still going to mess up sometimes? Yeah, exactly. But God's going to be there to forgive us. So if you know that you've sinned, you know you've done things that God doesn't like, and you want to be forgiven of that and ask Him to forgive you, then it might be time for you to become a Christian in this place. All right, next, you understand? Just like in one of the songs we sang earlier, that my debt's been paid. All right? A debt is when you owe something to someone. Like if you borrowed money from me for something, for something at the snack shack, or you needed a coat, then you would owe me that money back. But what if you couldn't pay it back? All right? The debt we owe for our sin is death and separation from God forever. But God paid that price by sending His Son Jesus to do that for us. All right? Our debt's been paid. We don't have to worry about that. So if you believe that God provided that way for us to have a relationship with Him by sending Jesus to die on the cross for us, if you believe that, then you may be ready to become a Christian tonight in this place. All right? And if you understand all those things, if that makes sense to you tonight and clicks, maybe time for you to pray and ask Jesus to come into your life for the first time.